Oh, this is not a spring chicken yet, while the rest of you are, oh, wait a minute, having record days. We're here in the Marina Del Rey, an area outside of LA, and believe it or not, see the wind blowing? It's actually really nice and cool. Oh, I know, I'm just making you jealous. Oh, well, you know, talking about jealous, do you think those other companies are jealous about how our stock market is able to rebound so well after a 500-point drop? Well, for now, we're
going to
bring Oldecam on with comments on the headlines of the day.
This is Oldecam for OFN, a news video with the comments on the headlines of the day. The market is up in the news that Obama is going to make an end run around Congress and use the Federal Reserve to get himself another stimulus program to pump maybe another $600 to $1 trillion into the economy that can't be paid back. I mean, all it does is it costs high. You know, the inflation that doesn't exist that everybody's paying will unfortunately get higher, but who cares though? Let's see, Obama kills AT&T purchase of T-Mobile, effectively killing off T-Mobile, thus accomplished the same thing as he wanted to prevent. That being, well, there's going to be less competition if AT&T buys T-Mobile. Well, T-Mobile is going under because it doesn't have the money that it needs to rebuild its infrastructure. And they're having to buy the rights to cell phones in order to get them, in order to stay in business. So if they don't have the money to rebuild infrastructure, they're just going to go out of business. When they go out of business, you have less competition than you had before. So, and then the stocks rack up month of gains. Ramp up month of August with steep law. But I mean, it's ridiculous, folks. The market is going up on wrong reasons. It's just worst months in a year, but it's still just gain. You know. Gain after gain after gain after gain in the past week or so on bad economic news. I mean, there's got to be something weird when the markets simply go up. I mean, the markets around the world are down massively, and ours has just barely had a trickle. Here we go. In Obama's legacy, a failed recovery, a double dip recession, the worst polling in history, and they easily expect him to win re-election because no one will dare stand against him, because if they do, they're going to get hit by the racism and everything else. But I heard people saying it's going to be we're going to simply describe it. We said before, like, my family's from Cicero. I know what Chicago politics is like, folks, and they are going to really get hit. Oh, a week ago, President Josh plan a week from today, and this is what it is. He's going to suggest a new stimulus plan, an infrastructure bank, giving people that are losing their homes for free, and more union hiring and higher taxes. I mean, that sounds an awful like everything that he's been talking about before, except this time it's going to it'd be unpatriotic not to support his plan. And at no time in any of the things does it say that, you know, he joined with the Republicans. It's always, they can join with me, and if they don't join with me, you know, they're against America. Another one, this latest thing, they had a riot last night over this one. Polls show Muslim Americans more satisfied with life in the U.S. unless they're not allowed to do as they see fit, then all hell breaks out. This is because a park banned women's scarves for all the women on rides, because the scarves can get caught up in machinery and stuff. So they had a massive riot there last night. Here we got Asian markets lower amid U.S. recession fears. They got the recession no matter what the president keeps saying, because they said, well, inventory, people are buying. They see the list, they had good sales data because automobiles are being sold and orders are being taken on airplanes that will probably never be delivered. Automobiles are being sold simply because the new models come out in a few days, and they're dumping the old models on the market to clear space for the new models to come in. It happens every August at this time. Let's see, polygamous sect leader Warren Jeffs responsive after fasting. Well, no, I mean, he's basically going to kill himself, and when he kills himself, basically, what do they gain? Nothing. So, we got Tropical Storm Kati again, strength expected to be a hurricane. Well, generally, this is hurricane season, and storms end up as hurricanes. So, you know, that's nothing. It's just like But they, at least they expect, I heard one guy said, they at least they expect this hurricane to actually act like a hurricane and not end up in a tropical storm like Irene did. But don't expect there to be as much hype because the hurricane's going to hit the areas the hurricanes generally hit and not move towards where most of the news media are headquartered. Here's another one. U.S. companies planning tens of thousands of job cuts because there is no there's no market for anything they're produced. 51,000 jobs are expected to be cut, which, you know, but don't worry though, because as the people fall, they're going to lose 51,000 more jobs from companies. But because of the way the Obama administration counts unemployment, unemployment's actually going to go down as more people are losing their jobs. I love that one. Here we got a Boy Scout leader fatally stabbed on Indiana hiking trip. Well, yeah, I mean, things get to be ridiculous, folks. I mean, Cub Scouts and Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts and little bluebirds, they never hurt anybody. They're just there to help kids. So, and then everybody seems to hate them anymore. Junior caught adding female defendant to a Facebook friends list. I mean, that's stupid. I mean, it's also a good way to not be a juror is to do something openly stupid like that. Okay, weekly jobless claims rose again. Consumer prices jumped 0.5%. And activity survey in this country, business activity dropped for the third straight month. And the houses are, this is Thursday. Yesterday, housing sales were, prices were rising. Today, housing sales are falling like a rock. So, Senator Baucus is in defect super committee trio, which means he basically wants to raise taxes and spend more money. So, banks, they said, are collapsing. Banks are just totally falling apart, mainly because of they're not loaning any money, so therefore no need to keep as many people working. 9/11 coloring book criticized for depiction of Muslims. Well, let's see, go to a Muslim country and see how they pick the Americans, folks. A rapper arrested in Ohio after organizing flash mob. Well, that seems to be the end thing to promote your record. I mean, we had in Southern California, they had a flash mob organized on a freeway. I mean, a truck was parked across the freeway. A flash mob formed, music was performed, and then the mob breaks up, but they caught the musicians. So dumb flash mob. Oh, cat, you know, Obama, you know, construction this month is down massively. Caterpillar is losing money hand over fist, but that was one of the great success stories of Obama's thing. But don't worry, quoting Obama, that every $1 billion spent on infrastructure will result in 30,000 jobs, so he intends to spend $1 trillion and solve the problem. The only problem is his infrastructure doesn't get done overnight. I mean, we've got road work being done by where I live, and the bloody stuff would just go, you know, it took forever to get started. They get hit by one delay after another delay because of the rules, and nothing gets accomplished. I mean, it can take years before any infrastructure gets started, but the money will be paid to the states, and the states will simply use it to pay their bills. And like they said, well, that money actually is put into the system, so that's good. Well, no, it basically doesn't get put in any system. It goes from the government to the states back to government entities. So the only people making any money off are the guys that are basically filling out the, you know, the typos basically filling things out. And they say, well, that's people working. No, because they do it with machines nowadays, folks. WikiLeaks website under cyber attack after releasing cables. Well, yeah, that's what happens. Things do get clipped like that, folks. And the head cold is going up. In the last year, $200 an ounce. That's a heck of a lot of money going up. Here's a U.S. outlook cast for kind of shadow over the whole world economy. Oh, but don't worry, that people shouldn't be talking about the negatives. They should be talking about the positives. How the economy is 1%, which is far better than under Bush, who was like about 5 or 6%. He was 5 or 6%, even though things were going bad. Obama is 1%, and things are supposedly going good. But then again, as I've told you before, how does a member of the Democratic Party count? They have to take one of their shoes off so they can count to one. They said Suicide bomber attack Afghan governor's compound. Well, that's about normal since they attack everybody's compound. I mean, you can't stop suicide bombers. It's a virtual impossibility. United States ambassador to China said they need not fret over dollar assets. Well, yeah, they do, because they pump so much money into this country to keep it afloat under this president that they worry about everything. You know, like Obama can't say anything negative about him because we owe him too pretty much money. We have Monty Bubbles, the Mark Twain of the Animal Kingdom. This is personal. No, I'm still not over being sick. When you lose your new email before you even get to use it, you're really having a bad day.